اثنين عم بيذيعوا اخبار ينشروا معلومات من خلال السخريه ما حدا عملها قبل.
منحدد بهالحلقه الجوانب المختلفه للانهيار بلبنان كخطوه اولى لنفهم نحن وين بالضبط قبل ما نسال بالحلقات الجايه كيف.
With the 2019 crisis, with the Beirut explosion of 2020, and with everything that happened, we realized that everyone kept asking, why bother with history? Like, the present is so prevalent. There's so much stuff happening today. Why do I need to think about the past?
كثيرا عم يرفعوا دعاوى على ناشطين وصحفيين بحجة انه عم يتعدوا على هيبة الدولة.
بدك تشوفي شو مفهومهم لهيبة قديم. المافيا عندها هيبة.
صح.
بابلو اسكوبار عنده هيبة.
So this is where the idea of the project came along. We wanted to link the present to the past. We wanted to show people that it is important to understand the past and what happened in the past. And once we do that, we can understand what's happening today and how to navigate the future. Why satire? Because we wanted the content to be simple and approachable for everyone. We knew that the content is heavy. And throughout the episode, there's a lot of heavy topics, heavy issues that are being discussed that we don't make fun of or make light of.
ما فينا نتجاهل خطر اندلاع حرب مع اسرائيل وهو تهديد بيواجه لبنان باستمرار واللي كمان بيبرر مكانة حزب الله وحلفائه وهيمنتهم على اجزاء
But
من البلد.
Between those to explain some minor ideas, to explain some things, we would use satire, we would use comedy. First to reduce the load so like the watcher doesn't feel kind of suffocating and just don't want to continue. To make it a bit more entertaining, to make it more approachable also both for the youth and for the general public. Because everyone has an idea that history is boring, history is rigid, it's only kind of from the book. So kind of mixing a bit of comedy in it makes it more digestible for people.
لبنان نادين أنه الماضي مكمل معنا على الحاضر. بما أنه معنا جنبي وقتها عم نعيشه في حياتنا اليومية.
إيه ليك هذا مخيل نايم قالا؟
لا.
And frankly, this was one of the biggest challenges, making it something simple without it making it meaningless was one of the biggest challenges.
ليك شي مرة متخيل السي في تبع مسؤول لبناني
أبيض مثل الثلج.
إيه إنه شو بده يكتب فيه إنجازاته؟
في يكتب ليستة السوبر ماركت مثلا.
إيه أو إنه يأيد عليه قوة الترنيب.
Some political parties maybe didn't enjoy the jokes on them that were said on them. But for us, it's also a measure of success when each of the political parties didn't like the jokes that was said towards them. It's like we made jokes on everyone. We included everyone because we felt that everyone is problematic and everyone had a certain responsibility. But yeah, the nature of the content itself, while it is funny, while we create jokes, We never intend to offend anyone. The main intent is to inform people in that sense.
دخلك الكبتاغون يعد دواء؟
مش عالمي لا.
طيب شو رأيك ناخذ بريك صغير؟
The main goal is for people to learn about the history of Lebanon and learn about it in the context of taking the present and looking back to the past. We want to also work with universities and one of university students do viewings and then have a discussion around them. We want to do some town halls in various kind of locations in Lebanon to kind of bring the project to the people, have a discussion with people not just in Beirut.
ايه الموضوع متعب بس بحس ضروري نحكي فيه يعني.
ليك برنار انا صراحه كثير بحب بس تعطيني رايك لانه بحسه انه ما بغير شيء على حياتي.